has had a real streak in field goals. He's hit five in a row on quite a tear, ready to tee it up and get it underway. Nice crowd on hand. They anticipate about 30,000 or thereabouts on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. And we're so glad that you saw fit to join us. And Shea advances on the ball. Hits it well, high and deep. Moving out of the backfield. That's Wilson. Fumbles the ball. It does recover, though, back inside the 10. Boy. On the recovery for Boston, big number 55, Bill Gump.
As they come back up the middle, veering to the right, he gets a little crack, tries to cut inside, but good coverage right there. As Oakland down very, very quickly, puts a shot on him, knocking the ball loose, and that could well set the tone for this football game. And the kicking game could be very important today.
Indeed, Boston does not have a great kicking game, either kicking it or returning it. Although Mazzetti is a very fine field goal man. First down for the Breakers at their own 9-yard line. Tight end Bale in motion. Woodward, the quarterback. Back up over the 10, out to the 12-yard line. Crump on the carry, and he is the best all-purpose back, and of course the best running back on this Boston lineup, Don.
Well, he is. He also is second on the club in points scored with 68, so he's a versatile guy. He scored four touchdowns by pass catches and receptions and seven by running, so they utilize him a lot. They're going to use him plenty today.
Second and six for Boston. The ball is at the 12, 13-yard line. Woodward, the quarterback, hands off to the short man. Over the 15 to about the 16-yard line.
You know, Tom, you talk about Crump running wise, and you talk about Tony Davis, where they're fairly equal in numbers of carries. But Dick Corey says that he feels that with their club, particularly if Johnny Walton's in, and he expects to have him in fairly early to see how mobile he is, that they have to throw the football at least 40 times a game to be successful. So it'll be interesting. Doug Woodward has not thrown that much. I think he threw 17 times last week, and we'll see whether the balance is there.
Third down at two now, and Woodward at his own 17-yard line. Oakland may have jumped. No. Out very close, but short of the first down. Up to make the stop, Manu Maliuna, veteran linebacker and one of the more visible members of the Oakland defensive unit.
Well, Boston using a pretty wide open attack. Use a lot of formations. They won't use quite as many with Woodward, obviously, because he hasn't had that much experience. That time utilizing the shotgun, one of the few teams that does. So we're liable to see a little razzle-dazzle here this afternoon.
Casarino's back to kick, and Gorton Banks, one of the top punt return men, stands at the Oakland 40-yard line. Casarino standing at the two. Boston getting one last man on the field. There's the snap. Big rush. Casarino gets off a short, low bouncer, coming out of bounds. The team at the Boston 48-yard line. Not the best of kicks, but perhaps considering that Banks was back there to return it, it might not be that bad after all.
And a good move by Oakland to put the rush on for the first time. They got Boston backed up. Casarino was let go by Birmingham as a punter. He hooked on with Boston, has been kicking extremely well, averaging the roughly 43-yard kick, has the league high for the longest kick of 72. That time, he got it off poorly.
Fred Besana, the quarterback now for Oakland, starting at the 48-yard line of Boston. Going to the air. Quick out, caught at the 40, and down at about the 39-yard line. Across the way, the catch made by number 32. That's Ted Torosian. Torosian is getting a chance to start. He's been on the injured list. Is backed off and starting. And
he's been out 9 weeks, I think, since the last time we saw them, Tom. He got hurt against, I believe it was Philadelphia. Good job by Besana there. He wanted to go upfield, couldn't see anybody. Excellent protection, was able to come off the 10.
He had a lot of time to throw the football. It's second down and a yard to go. Oakland on the Boston 39-yard line. Banks comes in motion. To get to the second man, a hole to the 37, 38-yard line. Louis Jackson, and the tackle made by Odious Lee. The officials eyeballing it indicate first down.
Out of the I formation, coming off the left side, initially gets the lead block, veers back up the middle, but there's really nothing there as that Boston front unit collapses it in a hurry. Those are three rookies up front doing a good job.
And you think he is an invaluable man? 57.3% of Oakland's rushing offense is accounted for by Arthur. In addition to that, all-purpose, he's 32% of the entire Oakland offensive attack, but he's not playing today. First down at the 36. Besana back to throw. Bumps into one of his own men and is going to be sacked at about the 38-yard line. And the guy in on top of him was Ray Phillips. As Besana had some time, but actually ran into one of his own people.
That's Ray Phillips' first sack this season. Besana dropping back. He lost Jeff Harper in the last play with an injury. Anderson is at center now. But really, the crowd gets to him in such a hurry that he can't get away. So Phillips registers his first sack.
Second down now and 12 yards to go. Banks is flanked to the left side. Torosian and Jackson are the two setbacks. Jackson on the sweep to the right. Turns the corner and slides out of bounds at the 34-yard line.
Pretty good bit of speed by Jackson at that stage, and it's a patented sweep where they pull both guards, and a key block by Raymond Chester right there. Almost got it started, but good pursuit, good force by the secondary, held it to a relatively short gain.
We're looking at third down and eight now for the Oakland Invaders. Their first possession, there's no score. Looking into the Oakland huddle, they committed the ball game with a mark of 8-8. And they have two games left to play. A win in either one would give them the Pacific Division title. Their third down efficiency, not bad. 45%, Besana with time. Pass complete. Jackson, short of the first down at the 29-yard line.
You know,
Phillips was there on top of it.
Fred Besana has led the league in passing as their ratings are concerned for quarterbacks, 12 of 16 weeks. But the last several weeks, he's been playing with a bad finger that he's used a splint on it. We'll get the call.
It's going to be a penalty against the Oakland Invaders, Don. Yes, he's been taping up the little the pinky on his throwing hand.
Yeah, he wears a splint during the week, and then in the ball game, he has it taped, but it doesn't seem to have affected him a great deal as John Ralston looks on and says, come on, fellas, let's move the football. Let's not get the penalties.
This one is going to take it back to the 39, and here's the referee's call.
Illegal motion, offense number 82. Third down.
82, of course, is Wyatt Henderson, who's having a dandy season, 53 catches, nine of them for touchdowns. That moves it back to the 39-yard line. And it's going to be third down and 12 now. And one anticipates Besana will go to the air. Backs are split. Banks and Henderson flanked left and right. Backpedaling, a rush. That's going to be caught. Down he goes at the 42. Great pursuit by Wilkerson, the big rookie out of Western Carolina.
Well, they use a stunt up front. You can see the people crossing just in front of you there, 73-71. Besana having nowhere to go as the penetration gets to him. The offensive line that has been playing quite well as a unit for Oakland broke down that time, but excellent pressure by the defensive line of the Boston Ball Club.
John, do you think that the loss of Harper has hurt that offensive line that much? It'd be interesting to see if Besana has a chance to throw the ball today or if he's going to be harried all over the place. Alley, the number one punter in the league, is standing at his own 44. Pretty good rush. He hits it high and far and into the end zone. It'll come out to the 20, and Boston will take over at that point. There's no score, and the Breakers get the ball. Boston did not have a first down in their first possession, so we'll see what young Doug Woodward, who had three touchdown tosses a week ago, is able to do now, second time around. He has Davis and Crump in the backfield. Smith in motion. Play action fake. Complete. Fine catch at about the 36-yard line. Pass is complete to Franz, and over on defense was Daniel. And Franz grabs the pass. That's number 60 now for Nolan this year. Number 8 receiver in the league.
And a very impressive throw by Doug Woodward off that play action. I'll tell you, he stepped back and put some mustard on that baby. He hummed it in there. Threw it on a line. Looked like a frozen rope.
Coach Dick Curry at breakfast this morning said someday down the line, this kid is going to be a great quarterback. But bear in mind that he is brand new. He's just in a very important game. And now jumping over the line is George Atiyah. And he, George says that they drew him off the line, meaning Boston. We'll see what the referee thinks.
On the offense.
Ball start against Boston. George was right. Boston quits playing, he's going to strike first.
Boston knew it. They turned right around and started walking back. That was Greg Horton that moved a little bit, the offensive right guard. So a little illegal procedure right there. And
it's a bit of a switch because Oakland's the most penalized team in the league. So now they point the finger at Woodward and company, and you see Doug walking up to the line of scrimmage looking over the Oakland Invader defense. No score on the delay handoff. Nice move out over the 35 by Crump to about the 37, make it steals to about the 36-yard line. Plummer was there to make the stop.
Good move right here by Steels as he starts to the right side, then breaks back to the left. You see the tackles missed a couple of them. A little acceleration into the hole, and then Plummer, the leading tackler for this Oakland club, immediately closes the ground and drops him for a loss. So he picks up a little over five off of it, but very well could have been two or less.
Second down, and they're calling it 9 to go. The ball is on the Boston 36. No score, first period. Boston comes to the line of scrimmage. Doug Woodward played his college ball at Pace University. And again, we've got just a bit of over-eagerness on the line of scrimmage by Boston. And Woodward is talking to some of his teammates, kind of like a Dutch uncle.
Well, Dan Hurley, the right tackle move. Bo Koch, tight end move a little bit.
You have
to wonder, looking at the penalty, and you see the penalty screen where they start moving the offensive left guard. Jerry Raymond was moving. They all jumped off. But Doug Woodward, although he played a week ago, you know, still, you need that coordination. There's a different inflection in the voices. Getting the signal.
But we aren't going to get any official word, but it was the false start.
So anyway, it takes a little time. And of course, you don't like to see those things happen, but we'll see as the game progresses how young Woodward goes.
Back to second and 14 at the 31-yard line. Hale coming in motion. Pass upfield, incomplete. Pass intended for Lockett. And a lot of people over on defense for Oakland, including Trent Williams, number 25.
A little bit of trickery, as you'll see Woodward dropping back, motion coming across behind, a fake action. It looks like he's going to throw a quick screen to the motion man, but then turns it upfield to the front man, Lockett in this case, trying to lay it into that crack, as so often does so many teams. They'll use that up the field a step or two and then drop back for a behind-the-line screen to one of those motion people or a wide receiver. That time, they went on upfield with the lead blocker, which would have been Frank Lockett if it had been to the motion.
So as Dick Curry looks on, we're going to take time.
Talked about with Woodward throwing downfield to Frank Lockett. Roman Gabriel said that they're going to pull out all the tricks today. We can well see several reverses, the old flea flicker. They got a lot of combinations of trickery in, and could be a very entertaining type of an offense.
Franz is flanked wide to the right side. Back to throw. Woodward has time. Downfield has his man tipped away at the last second. Fine defensive effort over there by number 41, Saladin Martin. And come on as a nickel, extra back. And Saladin did an outstanding job.
The ball in the air. You see Saladin driving on the football, just barely getting the right hand in there as Charles Smith is reaching for it. The fact there was a high snap out of the shotgun slowed Woodward up just a little bit in his release, giving Saladin Martin the opportunity to cover the necessary ground.
You know, Saladin did a fine job, but we gave him too much credit. Actually, that ball could have been caught by Smith, but Saladin interfered with him just enough, plus the sun, and made it a tough catch. Back upfield, that's Banks.
What a move.
Really a fine move, and then hit by the second man and dropped it above the 38-yard line. With no score here in Oakland, not played in a game for Oakland this year. Don Heinrich is a former great quarterback. That's got to be tough to stand on the sideline knowing that you just never get in, never take a snap, never throw the ball.
Well, this is true. He may play a little bit today if they were to get out in front, but at 38 years of age, I don't think he's too anxious to get in.
Handoff, second man, and flag down as the hit goes all the way up to the 45-yard line. Tackle Jackson on the carry, and the flag apparently is going to be against, it is, the Oakland Invaders. Tackle made by Ray Phillips. Very active.
You know, you talked about Livingston a little bit there, and the thought about playing him if the opportunity is such today that the Invaders were to get far enough in front that they could afford that luxury. They want to get a little work there.
We have holding on the offense, number 53.
There's first down. There's Jeff Harper back in the ball game. Gets nicked, but Livingston next week, they play Chicago. They'd like to have the division sewed up and let him get some work there and give Besana a little rest.
At the 29-yard line of the Oakland Invaders, we've got Besana back to throw. Has a lot of time behind the line. To the 35-yard line, and Torosian is the man who has it, brings it upfield, and Ben Needham there to make the stop. It would appear that deep, Besana is not finding anybody to throw it to, and they're giving him the short man right up close to the line of scrimmage.
Well, that's the type of thing when you're handling defense. I used to work with the defensive backs with the San Francisco 49ers and the defensive unit, that you got a long yardage there, like first and 25. You give them those little short ones, and they call that 3 yards and a headache. And that's just about what it was.
There's a last-second substitution dashing in. Coming in is Louis Jackson. And coming off the field was Mark Lewis. And now, because of it, Oakland's going to have to take time. They didn't get Jackson in there quick enough. And I would imagine that as Louis Jackson, that is, came into the huddle, he was saying, what's the play?
That's always an embarrassing moment. You're a person coming in, having played quarterback, a guy comes in late, you're just breaking the huddle, and guys are saying right 48 or left 29, whatever it happens to be, or a pass pattern. What's the count? He's running the other way. There's a little moment of confusion in there. It's difficult to coordinate everything all the time. You think, well, you ought to get them in there quickly. You ought to be able to get the plays off in a hurry. They are professionals. But there are those moments, and everybody has them.
Coming to this, the near side, is Wyatt Henderson. Flanked to the far side is Gordon Banks. The ball is at the 30-yard line of the Oakland Invaders now, and Besana's back to throw on second and 18. Incomplete. Into and out of the hands of Aldridge.
Well, that was a very catchable ball. Aldridge coming up into the inside and then releasing out. It was going to be a screen. It is a little high, and he does have excellent hands, but it was catchable despite the fact that he dropped that one. He's playing with a pulled hamstring muscle. He isn't 100%, but he also has the longest reception, which ended up in a touchdown for Oakland of 80 yards, and he also has the longest run, rushing-wise, of 52 yards. So he's got some speed, knows what to do with it. That time he dropped one.
The two completions by Besana have both gone to Torosian, number 32. Third down now on 18. Back to throw Besana. No, on the trick play, gives it to Aldridge on the reverse. Aldridge, quick reaction by the breaker defense, and they bang him down at about the 35-yard line. Phillips was there, among others. That's one of the few reverses and trick plays that Oakland has come up with this season. They've not done it at all, going for extra points or things like that. John Ralston, he's got a trick book. He just hasn't used it.
Yeah, well, they practice it. I've been out there any number of times, and they have it in their bag of tricks, but they don't utilize it. Pretty much of a conservative offense. That time it was kind of the old version of a Statue of Liberty type play. Instead of putting it up in the air, the back just stepped up, Aldridge in this case, then reversed around, pivoting wise. Besana stuck the ball behind him to slip it to him, but Phillips was on the spot.
Talley to punt it away, steals along with Wilson and Keith. Oh my, flag comes down, and the ball comes down to Wilson at the 13. Beautiful return, still on his feet, out of the skin portion and very close to the 40-yard line. Now let's see about the flag downfield. Well, great return by Wilson.
It really was, and this could be the best field position for Boston if, in fact, the penalty is against
the Oakland Invaders. So we'll have to wait till the officials make a decision.
We've got an illegal, ineligible man downfield, or one of the outside men, to put it more frankly, left the line of scrimmage just a step too soon. So I would imagine that Boston would refuse that penalty and they would take the ball and field position at the 39.
Yeah, they've had a little trouble getting started here. One of the players is injured right now at the moment. 52-yard punt.
An ineligible player downfield on the offense.
Here's the return coming back. Steps right up the middle, which is really great. A lot of times when they go side to side and try and set something up, poor tackle there. Bounces right off of that one and then keeps going. So that puts that ball at just about the 39-yard line, and really a good return by Woodrow Wilson.
Jairo Penaranda is the injured player coming off the field. Played his college ball at UCLA. And at one time was the best back in camp for the season for the LA Rams.
He's had a tough year this year. He's had a series of injuries.
So Boston now with a first down on their own 39-yard line. Great field position. Young Doug Woodward, the quarterback, to the breakers. See if they can generate something here. Play action. He's back to throw. Downfield. All ball. It is intercepted. And Oakland gets it back.
That looked like a volleyball shot as there were three or four players knocking that football around. You couldn't quite tell who got it, but
Daniel ended up with it. Number 29, his fourth interception, but it looked like a hot potato.
It really did. Watch it bounce around. First man hits it. There it goes right there up in the air. Marcus Quinn hits it. And then Daniel finally ends up with the football, as you indicated, his fourth reception or interception of the year. As Doug Woodward dropping back, threw that one into a crowd. Really, he should have been looking, because at that point, oftentimes you have to look at the backside as to who the coverage is, and that's where he got hurt.
Besana, first down on a spin around, is going to be dropped as the ball hits the turf, as the on-rushing Boston defenders are all over.
Looked like he wanted to go to Gordon Banks out there, and they were going with that little, as we talked about earlier, big pitch to his Besana's right, and back out to Banks on the left, who was split, and Banks had taken off upfield. And as Besana went to throw the football out to him, Banks wasn't there. So it looked like a little miscommunication.
Loss of five on the play, and it's going to be second and 15 now. There's no score. We're in the first period. We've got 5:11 to go in the opening period. Henderson to the right, Banks to the left, back to throw. Besana right over the middle, complete. Torosian, he's caught everything that Besana's thrown his way. Tackle made by Marcus Merrick, number 56. Linebacker on the left side. Torosian at the 41-yard line, call up the 42, and it'll be third down and roughly 9 yards to go.
Well, Besana really has not gone upfield with the football. He keeps coming off to those backs. Boston now with four down linemen rushing. Got a lot of rookies in that defensive unit for Boston. They've come along well. They have eight defensive starters that are rookies in this one.
Henderson left and Banks to the right, and Besana backpedaling. Now looking. Pass completed midfield. Poor tackle. At the 40. At the 35. At the 20. Down to the 18-yard line. Wilson makes the stop, and Jackson makes the big run. And some very poor open field tackling by Boston gives Oakland the biggest play of the game so far.
Well, that's what any young fellow, whether he starts in junior high, high, or college, let alone going into the pros, has been told on defense. You wrap the arms around them when you go to make the tackle. In that instance, two people went up, made the shot, made good initial contact, got the shoulder in there. They did not wrap the arms around Jackson. But give Jackson credit for some leg drive, some strength, as he broke those tackles, picked up a big game.
For Jackson, that's his 17th catch of the year. Torosian straight ahead. Good hard run, not much yardage, but a lot of effort by Torosian, as he kind of gingerly and then forcefully banged his way right up the middle. Wilkerson was there to make the stop, and Needham as well. And they've got the ball at the 16-yard line. Gain of 3, 2nd and 7. Deepest penetration for Oakland, and the biggest move by either team so far in this game. And the Invaders now with a golden opportunity in this scoreless first period. 3:10 remaining, as Oakland is at the Boston 16-yard line. Wide to the left is Henderson. Banks is flanked to the right. Torosian and Jackson. Whittington is out. Long count by Besana. Sideline effort. Diving grab inside the 10. Great catch by Jackson.
Little quick out move there, just about 5, 6, 7 yards upfield. Jumping around in there, you see Frank Duncan, the safety.
Cricket Banks was the man on the catch there and not Jackson.
I should say Charles Harbison that was jumping around as the catch made on the quick out. But Harbison, the strong safety, was jumping from side to side of the center. And you have to believe that Besana, recognizing it was going to be the safety blitz in some combination, chose to go the little quick out automatic and was successful with it.
They brought in Randall now as an extra tight end to bookend the line as they've taken Henderson out, they being Oakland. Looking for the first down, and Besana keeps it on the quarterback sneak. And it would appear from here that he's inside the 9 to about the 8-yard line, which makes it first and goal, Oakland. First and goal for the Invaders. They've got it at the 8-yard line of Boston. The big play was that pass to Jackson and the subsequent run by Lewis that took it on a third down and 9 back at the 42-yard line all the way down to the Boston 19.
And as a result of Woodward's pass interception, they gave him the football there. And, you know, coming into this game, giveaways and takeaways are so important. Boston had a plus 8, Oakland a minus 7 going into it. Big turnaround right here.
Jackson, Torosian, Besana being chased. Gets hit as he throws it. Is caught in the end zone by Jackson. Could hold everything.
Oh, what a play by Jackson at that point. What a grab and a tremendous reaction by Besana.
I thought for a minute, Don, he might have stepped off the sidelines when he threw at the end zone.
There's the fake. Besana moving to his right, and there again, Charles Harbison, the strong safety, almost had him, but just as Besana's going out of bounds, we're going to get drilled. A great reaction by Louis Jackson to step inside of the strike for 6 points. There you see again Harbison get a hand on him, but can't quite hang on. And really a fine throw and an excellent grab.
59 yards in that drive, 6 plays. Besana's 21st of the year, and the try for the extra point by Shea is good. Kevin has now hit 30 out of 34. Oakland leads 7.
He really isn't that much of a runner as he's rolling out to the right. Once again, a very alert Louis Jackson steps inside to make that grab. So, you know, talking with Dick Corey earlier, Besana getting a little ice in the back of his head, but talking with Dick Corey, he said he had a lot of hope, as you mentioned, that Woodward has shown a great deal of potential to be a good player. I said, well, you know, you get better by doing, and he just has to play. Well, Besana's played a lot, and he reacted well there, right there.
Steels and Lockett are back to receive, and that is Steels in the end zone, and he's not going to come out. He'll down it there, and that'll bring the ball to the 20, and Boston will have it first and 10 at that point. With that touchdown pass, Besana has tied for the lead in that regard, and there you see Jackson with a big piece of tape across the lower part of his chin. But he's grinning through it all.
Well, he doesn't mind when you get a touchdown.
That's his first touchdown catch of the year.
That takes some of those hurts away. You know, you look at turnovers last week. Boston, the scoring drive, 7 plays, 59 yards, 234, culminated by the 8-yard pass to Jackson from Besana. But a week ago, Boston had no turnovers. Oakland had 6 as they get a bad exchange down there in the field.
And the carry is up over the 20 and out to about the 23-yard line. That's Woodward with the football. And Monty Bennett was there. So give it a gain of 3. Call it 2nd and 7 at the 23 as they unpile them all. Woodward has completed 1 out of 4, and he's been intercepted. The last time he threw it, he was intercepted, in fact. And it subsequently led to a 59-yard drive led by Besana and Jackson and a touchdown for Oakland. And now Boston, who cannot afford to lose either one of their last 2 games. Crump coming outside, down the sidelines. Beautiful run by Crump, and he's in over the 45 and out to the 48-yard line, where he is driven out of bounds up to make the stop with Fred Williams and Daniels. Great run by Crump.
Really was.
The number 7 running back.
Watch the left side of the line. It's a roll draw action. Faking to the fullback, Tony Davis, and then as Crump steps inside, he gets the block between Raymond and Lewis Pollard, the left tackle. He accelerates well and down that sideline. Has good speed.
That's a 25-yard gain.
Bennett coming down the line. to see if he'll hop up. Little exchange of comments there. He says, I think you've been holding me just a little bit, Dan Hurley, the offensive right tackle, number 62.
Bennett was mad about all that, huh? Woodward hands off over the 50 to about the 48-yard line is Tony Davis on the stop. Cedric Hartman.
Well, there's an interesting play right there. Bo Koch, the tight end, came in motion down the line and tried to trap George Appiah, the nose tackle. That's an interesting type of a play. It's really a finesse play to keep him off balance. McLaughlin, the center, gives him sort of a soft block and slides away. The tight end comes down and cracks on him from the side, but, you know, they got about 4.5 yards out of it.
Franz is set to the left side. Combs, the tight end, is in the wingback spot and now goes in motion to the right. Woodward pitching back. Here's Crump. Beautiful move at the 40 to the 35-yard line. Crump running out of a very deep tailback spot, brought down by a plumber. Gets the advantage from being that far behind the line of scrimmage. Today he gets up a full head of steam and he's able to see the openings better.
And the guy that opens it up is the blocking of the tight end. They can't quite catch him in the picture downfield. I believe Bo Koch again, but he drove David Shaw, the linebacker, to that side 5 to 6 yards off the line and opened that gap.
End of the first period here. Boston driving, but Oakland lead. Of the Boston Breakers, 18 touchdowns, 17 interceptions.
What a record.
Came up with a banged up knee in that loss to Birmingham. Came back and played trying to get back into the lineup. And Dick Curry would like to use him, but he'd like to win with Woodward and save. But he won't, but we will see John later today. Woodward, quick pass, caught by Franz, and it's dropped. But let's see what the officials like to do. The officials are going to call it and forget it.
It has to be a completion. The ground cannot cause a fumble, and he was on the ground when the ball popped out.
The officials are going to call it an incompleted pass all the way around. That is a bad call, I believe. I think Franz had the pass.
Well, looking at the fake there coming off that side, it's a quick slant, and it looks like it's put away. You can't tell underneath whether it was trapped or not. Woodward now 1 for 5 with one interception. It's good for just 15 yards. A quick slant move, but they're still debating it down there, and it appears as though they're going to give it or rule it as a completion. And we thought they should.
Yes, and then just a moment later, why Oakland got the impression
first down.
They were going to give possession
as
the
complete pass on the
down.
They're calling it a pass complete. We've seen that happen at every phase of football where the questionable part of what is or what isn't a fumble, but as I indicated, the ground cannot cause a fumble. And in that instance, as he went to the ground, you see it again in terms of catching the football. He does have it put away. He did not fall face down, trap the football. He was to his side. Now it came out. It looks like a very legitimate catch to me, and a good call by the officials to readjust it.
Down 7-0, Boston with its best drive, 23, and the reverse, and coming to this side is going to throw it as Smith. Yes, lobs it downfield for the tight end. One-handed grab, but off the field of play. Great tag by Koch, but he couldn't catch it on the field of play.
Well, I think I called him Koch before, and I know it was Koch, and just a little late, and that's one of the trickery plays that Roman Gabriel said he was put in. Eddie looked to the backside. There was nobody over there for Charles Smith to worry about throwing the football. And Koch had to make a great grab of it, a one-handed type grab. As the ball is coming down, you see him stick up the left paw. Got the big hands. He's considered their best receiver. David Bale, their best blocker.
Crump on the handoff is outside. Great move. Hurdles through the air. Comes down at about the 15-yard line. And the football comes loose. Martin made the stop. They're going to mark progress and possession for Boston at the Oakland 15-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8.
Again, the roll draw action. He steps up to the inside, picks up a block right there at the left of the screen, then makes a move, but he's smelling that pay dirt. They know how important this game is. He just, what coaches say, you have to give up your body, and he did.
So the deepest penetration of the early going here. We're just in the second period. Boston at the 15-yard line, 7-0. Oakland leading. Davis is the up back. Crump is the deep back in the odd formation. That's the give to Davis. Straight ahead and pulled down as he grabbed. Crump going straight ahead. And to make the stop was David Shaw. Crump's got 48 yards in 4 carries.
Well, he's averaging 4.8 a carry coming into this game, and that's an excellent per yard attempt. You know, they talk about 1,000-yard players. But you have to look at how many times they carried the football as an injured player is down on the field. But, I mean, if the guy's carried it 5,000 times for 1,000 yards, then that average isn't very good. In Crump's case, he's carried a lot of times, but he's averaging almost 5 a pop. Fourth and one at this point, less than one, really a matter of inches. They've got to go for it. He's going to try the field goal.
Dennis Johnson is committed, number 39. He's back there, along with Crump, literally no more than 4 or 5 inches. And the quarterback, Woodward, keeps it. Flag goes down as Woodward started, got banged, fell away to the left and moved. And we may have a penalty, at least in the action from Oakland, indicates it's against Boston.
False start. That will settle it right there. The false start killed him at that stage, but that will settle it in terms of the field goal team coming on. You know, you say you want to come away with points when you're down there, but they're having a little bit of trouble moving the football until this drive. Now they moved it very well, and then they cost themselves with the illegal procedure move. So you say we got to try for the three. Get back into it. 7-3.
The ball is dead.
Tim Mazzetti comes in.
False start.
False start.
It'll be a fourth down.
Line of scrimmage is the 13. Well, they moved it back to the 18. And now Mazzetti out of off the bench.
Good job by the Oakland defense right there. You don't figure you're going to stop a quarterback sneak for less than 6 inches. Regardless, we don't know if he made it, but it certainly looked like it was going to be a very close one had not the penalty been called.
35-yard drive by Mazzetti, his longest, a 50-yarder, lands to hold, it's down, Tim hits it, plenty of distance, and it's good. So Mazzetti hits one through from 35 yards out, and Boston's on the board. And the Denver Gold not out of it entirely in the Pacific Division with a mark of 7-9. They are deadlocked with Los Angeles back at this Oakland ball club. So still a lot of possibility. Should be an exciting contest. Greg Morton coaching the Denver ball club. Of course, Spurrier has done an outstanding job with that Tampa Bay team. And John Reeves might be back for that one. So it should be a great night. That'll be Monday. And of course, remember, right after this game, you're going to see Arizona and New Jersey. A lot of football action for you on ESPN. The kickoff is very short. Taken by Lewis across the way. He's up over the 25, 30, 35, and down in a swarm of dust at about the 35-yard line. Down on the stop for the Boston Breakers was Bill Gump, number 55, in to make the primary hit. As Lewis brings it back on the kickoff, 62 yards, 9 plays, and Boston, as is most often the case, were our own worst enemies. They had to settle for a field goal, Mazzetti getting a 35-yarder.
You know, you talked about Mark Lewis. That was one of those instances where coaches said, well, who should we put back there? So they tried Mark Lewis. He now has the longest return, a 49-yard for Oakland, and is one of the better returners in the league. So sometimes you don't know quite where you're going to find him or when.
Besana, 6 of 7, has a touchdown toss. Hand off, straight ahead, big opening. Jackson is over the 50 to the 49-yard line. Oh, what a fine run. And Phillip finally ran him down with help from Harbison and Restick coming up with the secondary.
You see the left guard pulling out just a little bit, an influence kind of a move. And it opens a hole, Lewis Jackson taking it. What happens frequently is you see it collapse, good blocking by Steve Houston, number 66, the offensive left guard, to open up a hole there. Good job by the offensive line.
16 yards for Jackson, who has a touchdown catch, the only score for Oakland. They lead 7-3 and threatening now. Besana pitches back. Jackson again. Inside, outside, boom. Dropped as he gets to midfield. Gets back to the 49. Going to get no gain. Rustic coming up very, very quickly from the secondary. And over there also is big Darrell Wilkerson, a rookie out of Western Carolina.
Joe Rustic himself a rookie. Leads that secondary unit. One of the top tacklers on the club with 113 tackles. You can see why as he forced it in a hurry. Got up there quickly, and that's what you need out of defensive backs, that quick recognition and that quick force.
Second down and 10, Oakland. Wide to the right is Henderson. To the left side, nearest view, that'd be Banks, number 88. The backs are split. Hassan is your quarterback. 7-3, Oakland leads and threads back to throw. Over the middle, complete and dropped at the 45-yard line in there to make the stop. Merrick, and the catch made by Jackson, and Lewis is a very, very busy man indeed.
8 or 5 yards. Merrick dropping back as he looks at the move of Jackson coming across. And that's a play they used a lot with Whittington from his halfback spot on the left side. He circles down over the middle, cuts underneath Raymond Chester, and picked up a nice little bit of yardage.
Third and five now for Besana on the Boston 44. Oakland leading 7-3. Long count by Besana.
Movement inside.
Somebody did. We're calling it against the offense. We may have a false start there, or they ran out of time.
I think it has to be a false start. Looks like the right guard was moving.
We have a false start. Offense, number 66.
To slow him down a bit, take it back to the 49. It's going to be third and 10 now. Debilitating. Go from third and 5 to third and 10. If you wanted to throw it at third and 5, you desperately have got to throw it at third and 10. Ralston facing the sidelines. You know, John Ralston and Dick Corey, coach of the Boston Breakers, are close personal friends on and off the field. And each man is finding it a little tough to go against the other here today. You know, the first guy that Ralston hired when he was coaching Denver was Dick Corey. They are very, very tight.
Well, they'll be friends after the game. I think during the game, it's a little bit of competitive.
Third and 10. Back to throw Besana. Right down the middle, and it's complete. To the 35-yard line, to the 34, and a first down. Tackle made by Phillips.
Raymond Chester gets a good release to the inside. Comes down the middle, he's trying to uncover, and Besana makes a nice throw. Lay it just inside of Ray Phillips. And Bill Rowe, the inside linebacker, a nice throw by Besana, because that's a small crack in there, but he got a fine passing lane with the offensive line blocking. A lot of times those defensive linemen are up in your face. That time, the offensive kept him out of there, and he was able to hit Chester.
So Besana keeps the drive alive with a big 15-yard third down conversion. Nice to the left, Henderson to the right. Play action, Besana going long downfield in the end zone. Pass intended for Henderson, and it was just a step too far. And Besana kind of kicked himself up the side of the helmet, saying, just too far.
6 inches shorter, he said it would have been 6 points, and that was a good move by Henderson. He put a little hesitation move on as he went downfield. It wasn't a streak or fly pattern, as so often referred to. Just the tail end of it, you'll see him get one hand on it right there. Just tipped off the end of his finger. 6 inches would have made the difference. But Henderson sort of hesitated, like he was going to the inside, and then accelerated and flew by the secondary.
Lewis has come in now, number 80, and Torosian has come out. Jackson's the long shutback. That's Lewis to the right of your screen. Again a flag and a whistle from the line of scrimmage. And again, we're going to have a penalty. It would appear against the Oakland Invaders, either Markham or Houston, again making a move at the line of scrimmage. We'll watch the referee and see what it's called.
Well, you know, you can understand a
ball start. Offense, number 72. It'll be second down.
A few little bit of moves. You'll see at the top of the screen the movement right there as the official made the call. And he just stepped a little early. But as I started to say, that in the early going, the first couple of series, or maybe even the first quarter, you could expect that both clubs that are in the hunt for their divisions or the wild card shot, they're going to be a little bit antsy. But here they are in the middle of the second quarter. You would feel they've settled down, but they're both having trouble as far as their offensive line moving.
Again, Lewis to the right. Henderson and Banks are set to the left. Jackson, the lone setback. Second and 15. Besana dumps it off behind the line at the 40. That's Jackson. 25-20. Great run. Quick little screen. Up to make the stop, Jimmy Smith. But a big gainer and a first down at the 20-yard line, and Oakland continues to
blocking. As Besana drops back, stepping to the left, number 31 is Jackson. Besana sets it up perfectly. Good blocking out in front of it. Gets the offensive guard. Houston in front of it. Kurt Yonker helps out. But really, he didn't need much of a crack, because Louis Jackson is very impressive here as he accelerated. You mentioned Tom just took that little screen, but he didn't need much daylight. He blew down in there.
Jackson has the touchdown catch. Besana's over 100 yards with that pass completion. Now he's 9 of 11. An intercepted one. Jackson manages to find some running room and inches his way close to the 10-yard line.
Sweep. They used to call that the Green Bay sweep, where they pulled the both guards, the tight end, as you see the two guards pulling at that point. Frank Frazier, 67. Steve Houston getting the block out in front of it. There they are opening it up. Jackson cutting back inside of it. It's never very often a clean type of a sweep. It's always going to be sticky, as illustrated with the crowd out there. You kind of get a little alley or a little crack. I can remember Vince Lombardi, the years I played for him, he said, hey, you aren't just going to go around the corner, nobody's there. It's going to be a lot of folks, and you got to battle your way through it. Jackson did.
Mandelson now is an additional tight end, and a handoff, and Penaranda has hit at the line of scrimmage, but gets inside the 9 to the 8-yard line. It'll be second and goal at the 8. 7-3 in favor of Oakland. This drive started on the Invader 35-yard line, and they've had some big third-down plays in there, engineered by Besana. Jackson's been the principal thorn in the side of this Boston Breaker defense, and now Randall comes out of the tight end position, as they had two in there, and we've got Banks back in. Henderson flanked to the right, Banks to the left. Torosian is set to the right side, and Jackson to the left. Chester's the tight end, and he's split out a yard. Besana with a second and goal at the 8-yard line. Fred dancing about, running, flag down. Fred's going to be hit and buried, dropped back at the 18, closed in and dropped by Wilkerson. And there as well, helping out was Jackson.
Well, this is going to be an interesting call here. Besana dropping back. The pressure comes from the right side. He pirouettes around in a 360 going to his left. He's not getting any heat there, but he can't find anybody open. And then at that stage, it collapses in on him. But the call, they'd get an extra down if they take the penalty, yet they lost about 8 or 9
holding
yards.
Offense, number 72. The penalty is refused. Third
down. Refusing the penalty.
That's the thing to do at that point. Don't give him another down at it.
Back at the 18, going to be a loss of 10. It'll be third and goal at the 18-yard line. Fourth sack for Boston. But the penalty for Oakland continues to put them as the number one penalized team in the United States Football League. They've had a wrapped up about it.
Well, they have. Boston had 35 sacks coming into this game. They picked up 4 today. So their defensive line and secondary and linebackers are putting some heat on Besana.
Chester set to the left. That's Banks and Henderson to the right. And Besana to throw right over the middle. Incomplete. Good coverage on the pass. Intended for Chester. Fine coverage by Restick coming up from his free safety spot. And he was there to strip the ball away.
Well, Besana dropping back does get good protection this time. See the lane down there where he has a chance to put the ball down the middle. Restick closes it in a hurry. He jumps on Raymond Chester very quickly, and you have to consider that Raymond Chester is certainly always a threat. You're going to look for him a little more often than maybe you do some other people because of his long career and great ability to catch the football. That time Restick did what a defensive back should do. He drove on him and made him miss it.
Perche a third. 25, a 35-yarder. It's blocked. Picked up. Breaking downfield with the ball. All the way to the 15, the 10. Touchdown for Boston, and grabbed by number 59, Ben Needham. Oh, and guess where they got Ben Needham? On waivers from Michigan early in the year. So right now, driving for a playoff spot. This has paid off well, and he's been a good player. They're coming from the left side or the right of the screen. The ball is blocked.
That was Harbison who blocked it, and going into that drive, Jay had kicked 5 field goals in a row, which might be a USFL record.
Brent Besana doing the holding, but awfully good pressure too quickly, which means the corner didn't stay right with him. A very alert Ben Needham gets a good hop. The ball didn't squib away from him, so he picked it up on the move, and he's been a starter since he joined him from Michigan early in the season.
6'3 and 230 pounds, a rookie, and he ran like a halfback.
Yes,
as he
did.
Just ran away from everybody in a blue shirt.
Big play.
Time for the extra point now. Time's to hold. And Mazzetti's try is up and good. So, just that quickly, Boston's back on top. 10-7, the Breakers.
Needham, I don't think, is used to running quite that far. He didn't run out of gas, so he had some good distance between him and the people chasing.
He was pulling away at the end. Kickoff high, end over end, coming to Lewis, backpedaling in the end zone. And don't bring it up, says Jackson. So Oakland will come to the 20, and the Invaders will have it first and 10 at that point. Trailing 10-7 in a big turnaround, as it looked very much as though Oakland was going to at least add three more to a 7-3 lead, and quite suddenly find themselves down by three.
Well, Oakland moving the football very well the first half of this football game, and on the other hand, the Boston Breakers having problems moving the football on the ground. A week ago against Tampa, they had something like 222 yards total offense to 335 by Tampa. They're struggling here a little bit today, but football's a game of big plays, and Ben Needham just made one.
So it'll be Oakland taking over now. Besana, quarterback on his own 20. Hands off. Jackson straight ahead out to about the 24, 25-yard line. Jackson's really been the workhorse. Second down and six at the 24. Arthur Whittington, a 1,000-yard ball carrier. Really a great all-purpose back. Whittington, to give you an example, had caught 66 passes, two of those in the end zone for touchdowns, 1,043 yards and six touchdowns on the ground. He's out. Cracked ribs, can't play. Jackson's done a great job replacing him, but Oakland down 10-7 now. Besana, play action, time to Jackson. There's the ball loose, rolling in the dirt. Scramble, and Boston has recovered it. Jackson had it pop right out of his hands. Big number 71 in on top of it. Odious Lee, and with the football, the Breakers, who really now on top 10-7, seem to have momentum on their side.
Fake by Besana and the play action and going out to Jackson on the left side. Jackson catches it low, hasn't really got the football put away right there. He didn't tuck it away because he was trying to put a move on the defensive back that was closing on him so quickly. The ball jerked out of his hands. As John Ralston says, what can happen to us? We're moving the football up and down the field. We get a blocked field goal. It turns into seven. And now we turn around and give it back again.
So now with Johnson in there, number 39 is the up back in the I formation. Woodward hands off to Crump, straight ahead, breaks it inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. Flag down on the play. Oakland with two turnovers. Quinn came up to make the stop. It was a matter of turnovers that gave Boston a win a week ago. Well, holding against the offense this time.
That's one thing. Usually clubs that are at the top of the heap are ones that either create the breaks or take advantage of the breaks. They either get the fumbles, the interceptions. I mentioned that going into this, Boston was a plus eight, Oakland a minus seven. That means in terms of fumbles by your club or interceptions.
Holding on the offense, number 65, first down.
And incidentally, Oakland had six turnovers a week ago against Philadelphia, which cost them that game 12-6. Philadelphia leads the league in the plus category of takeaway giveaways with a plus 33. So that tells you something about that football team and Jim Mora, the type of club that he has.
Woodward has asked for a timeout as the ball is at the 25. Dick Curry paces the sideline. A golden opportunity for his club now with the ball on the Oakland 25, leading 10-7, to really do something about establishing a little dominance in this game. We've got 6:19 to go in the first half. And if they can put seven on the board here, why, they'll go up by 10. Woodward over talking to Curry now, and with him also, number 85, is Charlie Smith, who's the 47 catches, makes him the number two receiver on the ball club. As you watch the Dancing Girls, the Angels of the Oakland Invaders, you see the schedule for the United States Football League, week 17, Michigan and Chicago tomorrow. Birmingham at Philadelphia, voted though, and LA at Washington. Yeah, that Birmingham Monday night, of course, will be on hand. ESPN, that is, with Jim Simpson and Paul McGuire. Denver and Tampa Bay, a very important game for those two clubs. And that tell you, Michigan and Chicago. And there are some battles that are going to go right to the wire. And what a great initial season it is for the United States Football League. Following this game, you're going to see Arizona and New Jersey. Won't decide a championship for either one of the two ball clubs, but you get to see Herschel Walker and young Alan Risher, and Risher's right there in the touchdown category. In fact, passing-wise, Risher's got 20 touchdowns on the year. And bear in mind that 21 is the best any quarterback has in the league. And that's number one would be Hebert, and the guy that's right there with him is Besana, 21. It'll be an exciting game coming up after this one. Woodward, back to throw. Rush, screen.
Almost intercepted, really. And had it been caught, the screen would have gone a long way. Good pressure on Woodward as he gets back there. He should keep dropping back, though. He made a little mistake, but throws the ball behind Dennis Johnson at that point. Had Dennis Johnson been able to catch it, he had blockers out in front of him, and he'd have gone a pretty good distance with it. Roman Gabriel, the ex-quarterback with the Los Angeles Rams, and finished up with the Philadelphia Eagles. He calls all the plays in the press box. They go through Dick Corey, the head coach, and he mixes them up pretty well. That time he had the right call, but couldn't get the execution.
Shotgun now for Woodward. Back to throw. Being right, going to be hit. And just off his pins back at about the 35-yard line. Frank Duncan coming with a safety blitz. Woodward looked up and saw nothing but blue jerseys, blue sky, and then dust.
Well, there's the first sack today for Oakland. You see the twist up front by the two linemen and the linebacker, but 42 coming from the left. It gets in there quick. Is Frank Duncan the free safety? And both of these ball clubs utilize the free safety blitz, strong safety blitz, and they use the corner blitz. And both clubs are essentially passing football teams, so a lot of that type of thing is going to prevail. You've got to be ready to pick them up. That time they did not pick them up.
If Boston isn't careful, they're going to take Mazzetti right out of field goal range. Woodward's going to keep it on the quarterback sneak. Look at him run. What a great game gutty effort as he gets back very close to the 21-yard line. And the Oakland contenders are really beside themselves to think they're going to let this guy Woodward out of Pace University get away and run for pretty good yardage.
Well, other than the sneak, it's really the quarterback draw as he starts back two or three steps. Gets the good block there. Frank Malayuna, his number 54, was moving to the left trying to get off the block. He did with good running by Woodward to break to that left side. He just keys the block of the center or the two guards, whichever gives him the most leeway and create a lane, and he brought him back into the closer field goal range.
Mazzetti to try from 38 yards now. The line is set. Lance puts it down. Mazzetti hits it, and it is no good. Line to the left. Mazzetti had hit on 23 out of 30, and he comes up empty. Boston leads 10-7. Brought the ball downfield and put the touchdown on the board for Boston, ending 10-7. Besana takes over now at his own 21. He's 10 of 13, 115 yards, and an 8-yard touchdown toss to Jackson. First down by Oakland at the Invader 21-yard line. Besana back to him, dumps it off, completes all range, and he's hit and thrown down. Pick number 71 in there on top of the play was Odious Lee. Lee was there to handle that screen as the pass went to Aldridge.
Odious Lee, normally the nose tackle, but Boston, as it goes down to the tail end of this second quarter with just about 4 minutes remaining, has chosen to use four defensive linemen to try and get more pass rush on Besana, figuring that he's going to put it in the air. And that time, good reactions by Lee to get outside and jump on the screen.
Henderson to the right and Banks to the left as you watch Besana go back to throw. Over the middle, caught by the tight, no, by Torosian, coming out of the backfield at the 24-yard line. At the 25 is where they say progress being made in America. On third down and about 6 yards to go. Oakland trailing 10-7.
Had a clear foot in there. It looked like he was getting ready to cut him in half, but then he just made sure he made the tackle and he was going to drill him.
Halftime, Ford brings you the big plays, so we want you to stay tuned for that. Coverage of USFL action and, of course, of this game here and action the past week. Besana, third, six to throw, has time in the flat, complete. First down at the 42-yard line. Across the way, complete to Torosian. And a first down for the Invaders out to about the 42-yard line. Phillips made the stop, marked it at the 42, a gain of 17 yards, first and 10. Well, to show you that America is still the land of opportunity and success comes to the team who works hard for it. Torosian was a red hat for us here at one of our recent games here in Oakland, and now there he is out there catching the ball and performing in fine fashion for the Oakland Invaders.
And I bet he likes it a lot better being out there in the field.
Play action of Besana back to throw is going to go long, or it settles for a short effort to his tight end Chester, and it comes up empty as he looked deep and wanted to go for all of it, and then elected to go to the old Fitzman, who just did miss him by about an arm's length.
Well, he had an awful lot of time to throw that football. A good job by the offensive line, pass protection wise. Besana, while he didn't have it down the right side, looked to a second receiver, and really where Raymond Chester was concerned, he was coming from Besana's right to left, was the third choice in it. But by then, he just kind of pulled the string on a little bit.
Banks to the right, Henderson is flanked to the left. Besana with a second and 10 at his own 42. Caught at the 46-yard line. And the man making the grab is Chester, and Merrick is there to make the tackle.
Well, Raymond Chester at the bottom of the screen, releasing. Nobody slows him up at all. He just drifts into the center, right down the middle of the double zone that Boston's employing, so that's the vulnerable area. There's no linebacker in that immediate vicinity, but Chester, the technique of it is to adjust your speed so that you don't go too far and get behind the linebacker, or you go far enough to uncover from the other one, and Chester does it extremely well as we wind down to the two-minute warning.
That's it. The ball is at the 46.
Two-minute warning.
Oakland down. Tickets are now on sale for the first ever USFL championship game set for Sunday, July 17th, 6 o'clock Mountain Time at Denver's beautiful Mile High Stadium. To order your tickets, call toll-free 1-800-824-7596. Or if you live in Colorado, call 303-480-1232. If you'd like to order your tickets by mail, write to Championship Games, Mile High Stadium, 1900 Elliott, Denver, Colorado, 80204. Now, prices for tickets are $22, $14, and for the gold box seats, $55. There's the information. We'll repeat it for you throughout the telecast. The championship game, the 17th of July in Denver. Oakland now, the Boston 46-yard line. First down for the Invaders. They're down 10-7. We're in the two-minute warning area. Besana completes it. Torosian hit the line and out of bounds, and the flag goes down. He got to the 45 and then out of bounds. Flag on the play. And a penalty for roughing the passer. Personal foul against Boston. Oh, what a costly one that'll be.
That really is a costly one, because there was no reason to hit Fred Besana. The ball was gone, and it was extremely late. Boston employing the five defensive backs now. Besana
first
came
foul
out of the back, out of the back.
Defense, number 71, roughing the passer.
Must have been
first
a dead
down.
Ball foul, Don, because the line of scrimmage was the 46, and 15 yards had taken to the 31. They moved it to the 28.
In the right corner, Besana, as he goes back, the ball is going to be gone. Now you see the second shot coming in there that really is late at that point and very uncalled for. That's exactly the same way that Johnny Walton got hurt 2 weeks ago.
So a dead ball foul literally moves it 15 yards to the 29. Besana with the first down. Fired. I mean high, wide, and incomplete. He obviously wanted to go in the end zone for the score, elected second choice to go to Jackson, and then seeing some pretty close coverage on Louis, just ripped it away.
Well, he stepped up in there. He got a little crack to the right side. It sort of opened up for him, a lane. And he started to move like he was going to run with the football. With 1:48 to go, he could have run for probably a good 10 or 12 yards had he chosen to do so. But then he upped and fired to Jackson and just really threw it, as you indicated, high and away. Just like a fastball that sailed.
His one touchdown toss brought him to 21 for the year. He ties it with Bobby Abraham for the league lead. It was an 8-yard throw to Jackson. Now he's back to throw again. A lot of time. This one caught, beautiful reception inside the 15. The ball is dropped, but at about the 12-yard line, it'll be Jackson with the ball and the completion, and the snap is made by Jones, number 23, coming over to make the hit.
Besana drops back. Again, good protection. He has all kinds of time. You see the twist with the stunt up in front of it. He wanted to go out to the right, but came off very quickly to Louis Jackson. The fine adjustment by Besana to find him was like
mid-swing of his arm that he just kind of jerked himself around to hit Jackson, who came from right to left, circling out of the backfield. The five DBs were way back, and he picked up a big gain, so you don't have to always go way upfield.
We've got a minute 18 remaining in the first half. Boston leads 10-7 with the lead in jeopardy now. At the 12-yard line, and complete. Tried to throw it out in the right flat, down and out to the sidelines to Henderson.
Oh,
obviously a time play, and Besana threw it just too quickly.
Well, tell you, was he ever there, because Woodrow Wilson, the corner, was at least 10 yards off of Henderson at that point. And again, they had the double safety blitz coming that time. The quick out call, which is frequently an automatic that clubs will employ when they see the blitz early enough. Boston did show it very early. Henderson was wide open, but the ball was thrown for him.
But it's second and 10 now at the 12-yard line, and Besana with a golden opportunity to take a halftime advantage. He's trailing 10-7. He's back to throw. Over the middle, caught by Torosian, and he's dropped to the 8-yard line. Pretty good reaction by the Breaker defensive unit. Philip Rustic was there as well, number 36. Oakland's going to call time with a minute and 1 second remaining in this first half as Besana comes over to talk to Coach John Ralston. Ford will bring you the big plays. Tom Meade will be there at halftime. You'll see all the action from last week in the United States Football League and the big plays coming out of this ball game the first half today as well.
Well, you see an adjustment. You mentioned the linebacker jumping on it quickly, Tom. The previous play, they had the five defensive backs. Of course, they were further out, and they were playing it softer. And Louis Jackson made the catch and was able to pick up some nice yardage. That time, Ted Torosian, because they were closer to the goal line, less luxury of area to operate, came out of the backfield, and they jumped on it quickly. But Oakland does a fine job as it... You had mentioned the importance of Whittington, who is not in the football game, with all the receptions he has as a leader in that category. Now, regardless of who the back is, be it Jackson or Torosian, the last couple of cases, they're popping the ball off to him. But the thing that makes that so effective is they have guys like Wyatt Henderson and Gordon Banks, an Olympic sprinter with great speed on the outside to drive people off. And recognizing it, John Ralston uses that in his attack to utilize those backs effectively.
Well, it's third down and 3 at the 5. First down, of course. Or they can get a touchdown just five and a half yards away. Timeout remaining, one for each team. Jackson's caught 6 passes for 80 yards today. One of those an 8-yard touchdown grab. Torosian's caught 7, 51 yards.
Shows you how much they use them.
Third down now at the 5-yard line. Now Chester changes with Banks, who's operating as a tight end, now goes in motion, sent wide to the right. Lots of movement back there. Jackson rolling to the right is Besana, and he gets hit and throws it back for Chester. Well, that play really had more moves than a monkey with a new rope. I've never seen so many guys in motion going from one formation to another, and it was all designed to trick up that Boston defense, and the end result was to fake everybody and try to hit Raymond Chester, and Besana just flat missed it.
Yes, he did. Chester was complaining a little, felt that he was held. Doug Earhart, the offensive coordinator, is the one that calls the plays down for their offensive purposes. And that time, he showed them so many combinations, as you indicated, there was a little confusion on the Boston Breaker defense, and they got away with it.
22-yard field goal try now by Shea. The last one was blocked. This one he hits. It's up, and it's good. Now, Shea made 5 in a row, and then had it blocked and returned 75 yards for the Boston touchdown. And now Shea comes back to start what John Ralston hopes will be a new streak. At any rate, the 22-yarder has deadlocked this ball game at 10-10 with 55 seconds remaining here in the first half. So Shea, who was rolling along, had hit 5 in a row, suddenly has it blocked, touchdown returned by Needham. Now Shea gets the tying field goal at 22 yards.
Well, he's a local favorite from St. Mary's, just over the hill here in Moraga. And he started out the season not very well. He has a lot of fans that are out here watching him. And he's been something of a streak kicker, as you indicated. He went poorly early in the year, and then he hit several in a row, and then he, of course, coming off of 5 in a row, and then he gets that one blocked. And you look at this game, really, Boston, at this point, while they certainly aren't satisfied, they didn't capitalize the last time they were down there. They missed the field goal. But Oakland, who has moved the ball quite successfully, yet not put many points on the board, just come from behind to make it 10-10 and very easily could have gone ahead. So it's kind of a moral lift as far as the Breakers are concerned.
And it'll be the kickoff now by Shea, and it's a line drive bouncing down in front of Steele's, going out of bounds at the six. The flag goes with it. Illegal procedure. You've got to be able to handle the ball in the field of play, and so it'll be a 5-yard walk off, and they'll bring it back and kick it again. Woodward, when he gets out there to take over, has completed 2 of 7, and he has one of those intercepted, 28 yards altogether. That drive started on the Oakland 21, 74 yards, ending up with a 22-yard field goal. Very nice drive engineered by Besana and company. Jackson, Chester was in there for a couple of key receptions as they mixed it up quite well. And then they got a big Boston mistake, roughing the passer call on a dead ball.
They have an illegal kick. Out of bounds. 5-yard penalty and re-kick.
They're going to take it to the 30 and they'll put it down there for the kickoff.
Well, Boston at this stage, as we indicated, has not used their number one quarterback, Johnny Walton, who is suffering from that knee injury, and they had indicated they were going to get him in as early and as quickly as possible to see how mobile he was in there. But the fact that the score is close, if they could avoid utilizing him today, they would like to, and they're at 10-10, no problem with Doug Woodard handling the chores.
Wilson to the far side, and the ball is angled toward him, takes it to the 10, back to the 20, 25, close to the 34-yard line before he's brought down. I've got to believe both coaches, Shaw was there to make the stop, consider themselves very fortunate to be no worse off, or at least as good as the other guy at 10-10, when you consider that without Whittington, Oakland's at a disadvantage, yet Jackson and Torosian have played beautifully back there. And Corey has gotten a lot of mileage out of young Woodward, and now we'll see whether or not Johnny Walton indeed has come on, and John is out there now, as Dick wants to see if his somewhat gimpy leg quarterback can get him downfield in 49 seconds to see about getting maybe 3 to take a halftime lead. This will be an interesting series now, as Boston starts 1st and 10 on their own 35-yard line. Now he's operating in the regular position, not in the shotgun. Crump trying to turn the corner. Was out of bounds, chased out at about the 37. We thought, Don Heimlich, that Dick would put him in the shotgun formation to get him a chance to set up without having to put some pressure on the leg dancing back.
Well, you notice right here, everybody else thinking, or defensively speaking, well, here comes Johnny Walton into the game, a high percentage thrower, great skill in getting rid of the football. He only has 6 sacks for the season, which shows you how quick he releases it. But he starts out with the roll draw that has worked successfully for him earlier with Woodward in there, and that time Crump had nowhere, but he got out.
Well, here's John back to pass. Set, fires it. A diving grab at the 44-yard line, incomplete. Pass was intended for the tight end, David Bale, and Plummer was there on defense.
Well, as Johnny Walton gets into the game, if you can see the lower part, he really isn't as active. You notice throwing off that back foot, he's limping. He can't really put that leg down and plant, get that forward motion to throw the ball as effectively as you'd like, get that good velocity on it. That time he was a little bit short with it. So they're going to check him out here just before the half, as you indicated, and see when they come back with him in the third quarter.
Boston has not converted on third down, and they aren't going to do it this time either. Bump is tripped up and dropped behind the line. And so the experiment, or the try, by head coach Dick Curry comes up empty, and now Boston will have to kick it away, and Oakland now has some thoughts. Hey, we're going to have a half a minute here of action time remaining.
Worth the try.
Banks waiting. There's the punt. It's a high boomer. Banks standing under it at the 25-yard line, takes it with a fair catch there. And 25 seconds remain, as they'll mark it at the 26, and Oakland will have that much time, that much real estate too to cover, as they try to do something about a 10-10 halftime deadline. Oakland 1st and 10 on the Invader 26. We're tied, check it, at the Invader 21, and we're tied at 10. Besana has hit on 16 of 23, 167 yards, and 1 touchdown, an 8-yard flip to Louis Jackson. Oakland has moved the ball well against the Boston club, but no better than 10-10 with 25 seconds left in this first half. Torosian is the up back, Jackson is the deep back. Banks to the right, and Henderson is flanked to the left. And the pitch is back to Jackson. Breaks away from one tackler, breaks right through a mess of others, and it's deep downfield to the 42-yard line. Well, Boston's tackling leaves something to be desired. Jackson was stopped for what should have been a loss of 5 yards or so. Stepped away, ran right by about four arm tacklers, and takes it to the 40-yard line.
Well, a little pitch, conventional pitch, excellent force in a hurry at that point by Ben Needham, but then good footwork by Jackson to reverse his field and then breaks it back up to the inside. Jackson, who is a stocky little guy at 5'10 but 200 pounds out of Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo, and a great career down there. Remember, Shea kicked the 47-yarder last week, so one decent first down. He could get a pop. Screen pass, complete, 40, Jackson, 45, to about the 48-yard line. University of California at Berkeley, and he's sitting on the bench now, and he's telling the guy upstairs, listen, things are just kind of tough out there. I didn't see the guy on the sidelines, Henderson, then Banks drops it, and I'm getting a rush back there.
But
Walton's
got a tale of woe. He could tell, too, as he comes out.
He's 0 for 5 right now coming into this series of downs, and they're going to try and go again with Johnny.
You know, Talley hit a 58-yard punt a moment ago. Now Boston on their own 41 takes over. Crump is in there along with Johnson. Davis injured is out. That's Bale, the tight end in motion. Crump straight back inside on that counter play to about the 43. Give him two, second and eight as they unpile up. And Gary Plummer, who indeed played just a shadow away from where he is right now up at Cal Berkeley.
What a story he's been, too.
Oh, what a great season. Outstanding linebacker for the ball club.
Tackle at Cal, made the transition linebacker where you got to learn to get the pass coverage in. He's been pretty good in terms of interceptions. He has three. Boston is second in the USFL in pass offense, but just 20 yards today. So it shows you the defensive effectiveness of the Oakland Invaders and Doug Woodward and now Johnny Walton not having much success against it.
Dempsey just came off the field limping for the Oakland Invaders. He was pointing a finger at somebody in the Boston backfield. Walton dumps it over the line. It's caught by Crump at midfield. Good move to the 45, and a fly comes from way out of nowhere. The ball is on the turf and has scrambled for it. Hold everything. Up with the football, and they're signaling that it belongs to the Oakland Invaders, and there'll be a big discussion about this one.
And another flag goes up.
The guy who jumped up with the football was Dan Hurley, a rookie out of Nebraska. Or excuse me, Georgia Tia, first-year player out of LSU. And the officials will sort all of this out now.
And Bayou Bengal.
Now Oakland says they've got the ball.
Oh, what a break. What a turnover, really. Well, it's a delay coming from right to left. As Walton play action to the right, sliding to the right to pull him that way. You see it coming back over to the right side at that point to Richard Crump, who had delayed and slid out there. Now the ball slips out. He wasn't really stripped. He just didn't have it tucked into that elbow. And you hear coaches frequently say, don't carry it like a loaf of bread. Well, Crump, because he tries to run so hard.
Run by 84 White. Fumble. Recovered by Oakland. Personal foul.
I still don't know what those flags are all about.
We couldn't quite get it there. A different angle as Crump coming across. The tail end takes the little shot. The ball pops free. But coaches are always saying, you know, don't carry it like a loaf of bread. Put that ball away. Tuck it into that arm. Wrap it, and when you're going to get tackled, put the other arm around it if you possibly can.
Big walk-off against Boston, and boy, are they unhappy. Now to their 37, and Oakland's got a magnificent break.
What an opportunity for Oakland at this point, because Boston seemed to have generated some offense much better than it had been at the seventh penalty for 50 yards against Boston, and possibly the most crucial of the day for them, certainly up to this point, as they are leading 13-10, but excellent field position,
possession
for the Oakland Invaders.
54-1. First down, Oakland.
Nick Gurry was a very calm man on the far side of the field as he talked with his quarterback, Walton. The greatest running back that ever carried the ball, Jimmy Brown, has a great theory about how Crump carries the ball. Crump carries the ball like a running back. He said the closer you bring the ball to your body, the more you go from being a running back to a fullback.
the more you go from being a guy looking for 50 yards to a guy trying to make one or two. Besana out in the flat. Torosian drops it. It's picked up. Oh, they aren't going to call that a completed pass. Torosian had it in his hands. I've got to see the replay on that.
I don't think that that was a completed pass myself. It looked
see
like
how long he had it.
I thought it was Gordon Banks out there that was reaching for that ball. But it certainly wasn't put away in any event, as he is well aware. It is Wyatt Henderson. Hard to distinguish these numbers. We hadn't mentioned that earlier, but I think probably these two clubs are the most difficult jerseys to read of any clubs in the league.
Had alibi.
The color scheme. Well, we blew that one.
Jackson dips his way outside and back inside to about the 33. Billy Don Jackson tackles Lewis Jackson.
Well, you know what you have to say, though, Tom? We're down to the last game of the season as far as you and I are concerned. And if we are slightly in error on one, not all bad.
At the 33, 6 of 13 third down conversions by the Oakland Ball Club. We've got 2 minutes remaining third period, 13-10. Boston leading, and it's been kind of a case of giveaway, an Alphonson Gaston routine here.
A lot of drop balls.
In this third period, first one team, then the other, appearing to have an advantage, and now big third down time for Besana. So far, he's been brilliant. A lot of time. Incomplete. Oh, we're going to have a pass interference call on Merrick. Jackson, the intended receiver. Merrick's going to get nailed for a pass interference.
Automatic first when it was third down. He could have made the tackle. They wouldn't have had the first.
Now the official is waving John Ralston off.
As Besana throws the ball, you can see Merrick is all over Jackson. He's wearing him like a second jersey. That really gives the Oakland Invaders a life at this point. Two costly penalties. You mentioned the one
defensive pass interference
after the fumble recovery.
56.
Now with the third
first down,
relatively long situation. The pass was short. Would not have gotten enough for the first down. Merrick guilty of pass interference. And the Invaders with new life at the 17-yard line.
Well, that's like having the warden walk in at about a minute to midnight, isn't it? What a break. Straight ahead, Jackson. Inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. And the Invaders, gifted with about 40 yards in penalties, now can smell the end zone. Harbison makes the tackle.
And just a straight dive play out of the old T formation type of thing. But with the backs just going straight ahead, zone blocking, man on man, you knock them back. And Jackson, who has got great quickness, just blows up in there. And boy, did he get a nice little crack and took it in tight.
Measuring for the first down. If it is, it'll be first and goal. Any part of the ball.
All he does is read the guard or the tackle block on it. If the lineman, defensive lineman goes one way or the other, or the guard is shooting out at the linebacker and the free man, it is a first.
No.
No, it is not.
Just about an inch.
About 2 inches.
Yep. Or two. But he really has nothing to concern himself with other than the reaction of that offensive lineman. Or the defensive lineman. The defensive lineman goes one way, he veers the other. That way, he had plenty of running room and did his job.
Jackson and Torosian behind Besana. Henderson right and Banks to the left. Besana going for all of it. Incomplete in the end zone. Another flag comes down.
Oh.
This could be offensive pass interference. Hold on.
I don't think so. I think it's going to be on the defense, but I sure question the call at this point. It was the quick post move, the toughest pass in football to handle. As Besana dropping back, it's like a 3 or 4 step drop. You know, it's kind of hard to tell whether at that point Woodrow Wilson was all over it. But I can tell you one thing, Woodrow Wilson was too far off of him on the initial release off the line of scrimmage. When you're down there tight, it's a one-on-one dogfight. You get right up on
defensive
that
pass interference, number 20.
Officials
half the distance to the goal line. First down.
Yes, Boston, but it's a dogfight. You just, you and him, and you don't get him any kind of room, and Wilson did, and then he jumps on him on top of it.
Well, there's been two pass interference calls.
and a personal foul call all against Boston. And with it, Oakland has moved right straight down the field to a first and goal at the three, trailing 13-10. But the Breakers have really done their level best to give it away.
Oh, good defense.
Torosian nailed as he tries to come back inside. Might have gotten a yard. It'll be second and goal and probably at the 2-yard line.
These are really tough yards down in this area. Just a little power handoff move, but good pursuit by the defense as a host of tacklers are in there. You mentioned all those penalties. Would you say that the boys from Beantown are beating up on the Oakland Invaders at this point, but their penalties are costly to them?
I would say they're their own worst enemies with all of those personal fouls and pass interference calls.
Are they ever?
A victory for the Oakland Invaders would clinch the Pacific Division title. Denver most interested in the outcome of this one. Straight ahead, Torosian again. At about the 1-yard line, it's going to be third and goal for the Invaders at the 1-yard line of the Boston Breakers. This drive started at the 37 following a fumble recovery. And then a couple of pass interference calls, a personal foul call tacked on. In third down, Oakland has converted 7 of 14. Well, the last one came via a pass interference call.
What do you do here? You've had trouble logging yards on the down, on the ground, but now it's come to the end of the quarter, so they get a break to talk it over.
13-10, Boston lead after a fumble recovery. And now, third and goal at the 1. The running backs are Torosian and Jackson. Besana, the quarterback. And Penaranda in motion. They give to Torosian, and he's in the end zone. He followed Penaranda, who turned back into the line, and Torosian puts it in the end zone to make it 16-13 in favor of the Invaders, and we'll see now about the extra point.
And one of the players hurt. See the motion coming across, so that changes the strength from the right to the left. You see the surge of the whole offensive line, but really a good low body lean by Ted Torosian. You see, there's the action coming that way. Now watch Torosian drop down low, smelling that goal line as he gets a surge from the offense. And you talk about chess games. When you try and move those people around, you try and outflank the defense. They didn't have much success to the inside, picking up a yard or two here and there, hard yards. So now they go wide with one more angle at it, coming to the right of your screen, a little pitch back there, just a power type of a play. You see the surge of the offense blowing them back. They don't get much, but they get just enough of a crack for Ted Torosian to slip into the end zone, and one of the Breaker players is injured down there.
Points after, conversion rate for Shea, has won today, came into the ball game with a 29 of 33 in that regard. Jay hits it up, and it is good. So, big play, and a big touchdown. And Oakland goes back. Philadelphia's already clinched the Atlantic Division and the playoff spot that goes with it. And it's quite a scramble among the others now, as you see Chicago, Michigan, Boston, and Tampa Bay from 11-5 to 10-6 their record. And Boston admitting that they need to win 2 games to have a shot. Oakland, Denver, and L.A. And if Oakland wins one of their last 2 games, and they're leading in this one, Denver and Los Angeles can't forget about it, because the Pacific Division will have gone to the Oakland Invaders. And they lead now 17-13, up by 4. 37-yard drive, but bear in mind, it started out with a big personal foul call. Kickoff is at the 35-yard line. 37 yards in 6 plays and a 2-yard run by Torosian to go on top 17-13.
Not bad field position right now, though, for the Breakers. And the fourth quarter has been a big quarter for them. They've generally outscored their opponents significantly in the third quarter stats. Oakland has fallen off in the rushing category. Boston's on top there with 150. But passing, significantly different for Boston, the second-place club. For offense, throwing the football, only has 33 yards.
Bale in motion, and Walton gives the ball to Crump, who is hit, gets over the 35. Second down and a very long 8, almost 9 yards. I formation, that's Crump as the tailback. Johnson is the upback. Walton the quarterback. And Crump again trying to go outside. Breaks a tackle, gets a couple. He had a lot of trouble getting away from big Randy McClanahan.
The Boston Breakers have run a lot of draws in his area. The linebackers closing that one in a hurry.
Third down now, and Walton's operating out of the shotgun. He's got Franz wide to the right. Big rush. Walton back, throwing it long downfield, going to be tipped away. Intended receiver was Smith. Tipped away by Saladin Martin right at the last second. Fourth down, and Boston will have to punt it away.
And could have been picked off by Saladin. The secondary dropping back. You see the two deeper people going to the outside zones. The up people taking the short areas. Saladin cutting across in front of Smith at that point. And really not a well-thrown ball. I don't think that, quite frankly, Johnny Walton can get enough mustard on his fastball. And it isn't getting there in a hurry, and Saladin conceivably could and should have picked that one off.
Cazzarino to punt, steps up and hits it. Nice one. Waiting for it is Banks. At the 20, gets bumped, flag goes down. Another flag comes in. I don't know whether Banks was bumped by a white or blue jersey.
Well, they didn't give him a chance to catch the football, so I'm sure it's going to be against Boston.
Yeah, he was bumped, but it could have been bumped by a blue jersey. One of his men was back there.
Well, we'll get a decision here in a moment from the officials.
Take another look
there
at it.
There it is again as Banks steps up. He got popped just a little bit by that first man down, but he did not signal for a fair catch either. Very alert play as far as the recovery is concerned. Got the good hop there.
He did not signal for the fair catch.
Well, they got to give him an opportunity to catch the football.
Well, I thought he had the ball when it was knocked away from him.
Not really. You see right here? There comes the ball.
True. He did not
bang.
Hit the ball.
He takes the shot at that point. So it's a very, very good call by the official. And another bad error as far as the ball.
Interference with the opportunity to make a catch. Number 42. First down.
There it is.
Dick Corey will have a lot of them to look at from this game film. His team gave up two pass interference calls, a personal foul call that enabled the Oakland Invaders to march down for their eventual two-yard run for the score by Torosian, and now they open up, giving the possession to Oakland, and add 15 yards onto it, taking it out to the 35-yard line for interference and not allowing Banks as the receiver to have a clear shot at picking up the football. So they've been their own worst enemy, the Boston Breakers. They're down 17-13. A lot of time left, but the mistakes are really killing them. And now Oakland with a chance to put them away. Jackson hit from behind.
Showing double coverage early.
Underneath, that's Jackson, straight ahead to about the 38. Third down and six at the 39. Oakland's been tremendous in third down conversions. Besana with a ton of time over the middle, and again, the officials are going to mark it very close to the 45-yard line, and wherever they put it down, and now look at Boston arguing with them about that, pointing back the other way. Ooh. The spot indicates first down, and that's the call for the road. Oh, boy. Yeah, Oakland's gotten every play, every call.
An open spot. Well, that was Fred Besana's 23rd reception out of 33 attempts. And he's continuing to hit those backs out of the backfield. His high for the season, he had 330 yards against Michigan in one game. He had 27 completions against Tampa for his high in that area. He had four TD passes against the Washington Federal. So he's bordering on his high of receptions at 27 versus Tampa, now having 23.
At the 45, Oakland leading 17-13. First down, Jackson on the sweep. They made a sandwich up.
Then they pick up the first down. Now they've driven to midfield. In the event they do not pick up this third down, they're at least going to kick it virtually to the other end of the field.
Third down for Besana. And about 5 yards to go. At midfield, Fred back to throw. Lobs it down the side. It is incomplete. Boy, and did he get level.
Oh, and was the blitz coming.
The blitz coming from Resting, the Notre Damer, who just, like a runaway locomotive, barreled up the middle to nail Besana.
Well, as you see the both linebackers coming up, they open up the middle. Here comes Resting, number 36, right down the middle. You don't see him hit Besana. Besana lets it go in a hurry, and that's called self-preservation. He laid it up soft, but just a little bit out of reach.
Jackson was just a step away from pulling it in, which would have been still another third down conversion. Talley back to punt, hit a 58-yarder, which was preceded by an 11-yarder. Number one punter in the league, obviously atoning for a shank. He was actually trying to kick it inside the 20 and
literally shanked the ball out of bounds, an 11-yard punt. Now he's got a 58-yarder a moment ago, and
almost up to his average.
Really. Hits this one kind of low. At the 15, steals 20 and out of bounds. They'll mark it at the 22, 23-yard line. Well, it's 17 to 13 in favor of Oakland. Boston gets the ball back. As Boston takes over on their 23, Crump has 114 yards. Crump came into the game with 796. He was the number seven rusher in the United States Football League, statistically speaking. And now Johnny Walton, who's completed only 1-7, has got to get his ball club galvanized into action. He's down by four, needs a touchdown, a field goal is no good. Walton comes to this side, has a man, had plans, but couldn't connect with him.
Out of sync, just has no rhythm to it.
Smith and Franz are flanked to the left side. Lockett is set to the right. Walton to throw. Downfield has a man. It is caught by both guys. Saladin Martin is one of them.
This is going to be interesting.
Going to go to the offense.
It should.
If both men have a hold of it, the ball goes to the offense.
That's
and Boston will have it at the 47.
Oh,
this game's had everything, huh?
Well, yeah, and Saladin actually, you know, he had that interception clean. But an excellent job at that point by the receiver to get his hands in there. Saladin had not put the football away. And as they went to the turf, he jerked it away from him. Or at least if they both had their hands on it, the possession goes to the offense. Good call.
Trailing 17-13, Walton right down the middle. Caught by his tight end. Fights his way to the 40, 35-yard line. Koash has Walton went right up the middle, and Koash drops it. As Walton was trying to put a drive together, back to throw, John steps up, throws, has a man, Smith, at the five, and goes out of bounds. Had Smith been able to maintain his balance, he'd have been in the end zone.
He sure would have.
Oh, how could he keep from going to the end zone as he caught it and went out of bounds, and I think Smith is having some second thoughts.
Walt, this is one of the few times, but still laboring a little. Hits down the right side of the zone, and they really don't get there quickly enough. Had the ball been a little more to the inside,
done.
He would have been able to
stay. I think Smith stepped out of bounds. I think he misjudged the line mark. Watch as he seems to be all alone, room to run, and he's got a yard to go, and now he goes right to the sidelines and steps out. Look at that. Took two steps.
He well could have. Misinterpreted where he was on the field, but a breakdown in the secondary and a fine throw by Johnny Walton.
First and goal at the 5-yard line. Smith in motion. Walton trying to get his club on top. Crump is at the 5. Crump is in the end zone and a flag goes down. Oh, is Boston his own worst enemy?
Had he realized where he was on the field. The ball wasn't that far to his outside. Boston's 11th penalty for 110 years.
Illegal use of the hands. Offense, number 64.
They called it on Greg Horton, and Horton is beside himself, a 7-year pro out of Colorado. It is now first and goal back at the 15. But 17 to 13 in favor of Oakland, and Boston just keeps...
Dick Torrey looking at his play chart there. He says, what do I call now? I mean, we got in the end zone, and as we were talking about Smith, the momentum of the ball or the angle of it really wasn't enough to take him out of bounds. I believe you're right. He just forgot where he was.
Walton to throw. Right down the middle in the end zone, tipped away. Tried to get it to Smith, and tipped away at the last second. Saladin Martin was one of those who got a hand on it. Shaw might have got another one there. So it'll be second and goal at the 15.
Holding both backs in, trying to give him maximum protection. He fires it right down the middle. Takes a little chance as he put it in the crack, but Walton anticipating where the receiver's going to be, Smith in this case, at the tail end, you see just a little bit of a deflection there and enough to throw the ball off. So it goes to second and long.
Second and goal at the 15-yard line. Boston has already scored, only to be called back for a penalty. They started this drive on their own 23. Walton trying to pull him from behind. Pass is thrown, caught, dropped at the 7-yard line. So it's going to be fourth and goal at the 7. Fine defensive effort. It'll be third and goal at the 7. Duncan was there to make the tackle. They have not converted on a third down attempt out of 8 previous tries. And now a conversion would obviously get them a touchdown. Third and goal at the 7. And now a timeout is being asked for.
Trailing by 4 points at 17-13. A very smart timeout at this stage by Johnny Walton to go over and say, look, we're at the seven. We have not moved the football as well as we would like.
Play action fake. Walton throwing in the end zone. It is tipped away. Incomplete. They tried to get the ball in the end zone to Smith. And Derek Barton was there to tip it away. And now they apparently, being Boston, will settle for three with 6:04 to go. And I guess hope that they get to come back down the field and maybe get another three.
And really a bad choice by Walton at that stage, although he did get a little pressure. He's throwing it right into a crowd. He was actually fortunate that it was not picked off. When you got two people sitting over there, Derek Martin, Saladin Martin, really foolishly put it into a crowd that way, but maybe get three.
Mazzetti trying. It'll be a 24-yarder, and it's good. So Mazzetti now kicks his third field goal, and the cheese gets a bit more binding. Oakland 17, Boston.
Well, they could have scored twice down there, like said on Smith's pass. And they come back, and Crump takes it in, get the holding penalty, so they're really killing themselves.
Kickoff is high, going to the far side to Lewis. He's back to the 5. The 10, the 15 is hidden, still on his feet, struggling, but was blown dead at about the 17-yard line over in the dust around where first base would be if the Oakland A's were out here this afternoon. They're going to mark it at about the 18-yard line. 9 plays, 70 yards. Mazzetti with a field goal to draw the breakers a bit closer. But again, Boston has been its own worst enemy from errors of omission to commission. The 18, first and 10, Besana going to throw it. Over the middle, complete. And Jackson's out to the 29-yard line, make it the 30.
Good balance by Jackson. Got a little stiff arm down there. Bounced off that first tackler, warded him off as he circled out of the backfield. You have to wonder a little bit on Boston's side of it.
Whoops, the flag goes down. Now we've got Jones down there, number 23, with the helmet off.
Oh, that's a bad mistake. That's the first
thing you never take your helmet off.
Oh, never.
Mercy, no.
If you happen to have it off at a sideline, you run over and put it on.
Jones is, that flag is going to be a personal foul call, and Jones apparently
personal foul.
Shaken up and hurt.
Offense, number 82. After the change reset.
Going to be called personal foul on the offense, Wyatt Henderson. Henderson and Jones probably have been having a little tete-a-tete with each other all day, and it just erupted. Remember, this is the most important game of the year for both of these clubs. For Boston, probably more important than for Oakland.
Well, Wyatt Henderson getting that personal foul call as Jones goes out of the football game. He knows what it's like to play defense as he came into the NFL as a defensive back for a period of time. And he bounced from the Los Angeles Rams to the San Diego Chargers.
Wide to the right side, back to the left. Besana back to throw, rolling to the right. They run it. Does not get the first. Phillips and McLean are the two men that are shaken up.
Besana moving to the right side. Good job by the secondary. They stayed with the people instead of letting them go. It's called get on the ground and try and keep from getting killed. Good job by Besana.
Tally to put it away, and Wilson and steals. Oh, a high snap. He pulls it down and hits a low end over end. Coming down to Wilson. Takes it on the 30. Hesitates, and he who hesitates is lost.
Oh,
Rands along with Smith, flanked to the right side. Big rush. Dumps it over the middle. It is tipped away. Incomplete. At midfield, Johnson, the intended receiver. The ball tipped away. Great play in there.
At fourth and four.
At their own 43-yard line. Might be the last play of this game for Boston. Walton has time going long downfield. He's got a man. Throws it too far. Head. The ball been able to make connections with Lockett, it would have been a touchdown for Boston, and they come up empty, and the Oakland fans now feel they've won the division as they've got a one-point advantage with a minute 49 and book the division. They'll wipe out any thought of a championship or a playoff game for L.A. and Denver.
Well, can you believe that? You gamble on fourth down, go for all the marbles.
No, I can't believe that.
And not only that, but you have the man wide open and you overthrow him by 3 or 4 yards. They have managed defensively to be in the right spot at virtually all the right time.
But it's been a tough, frustrating day for the Breakers and for their coach, Dick Curry, who has had a tough way to go. Contrasted on this side, of course, the elation and joy of this Oakland ball club. Nobody ever asks how, just how many points that is and victories, and they're just a minute and 29 seconds away from winning the Pacific Division and going on to the playoffs. At the 43 of Boston, second down and 10 for Oakland, and he's going to eat up the clock. Torosian hurdles one man, gets inside. Needing only four, he went for about 80, or at least 60. Torosian trying for the first down, gets to the 36. So they'll be bereft of those when they get the football back. Clock will not start until the ball is snapped, and now it comes back to Talley, and he sidelines it. No, he's going to drill it in the end zone. Not his best effort. That's going to bring it out to the 20. He certainly didn't want to do that. Back to throw. Prevent defense. Dumps it out of the side. Passes caught at the 20, 25, and out of bounds. And Walton trying to get somehow his team downfield. Going to be sacked and thrown for a loss. 11 seconds remain in the game, and if it stays as is, why, Oakland will have clinched the Pacific Division title and the playoff spot that goes with it. Whoever wins the Pacific, there'll be a traveling team come playoff time on the 10th. Walton has got, he's the only man behind the line of scrimmage, and he's back to throw. Needs a first down. Downfield, intercepted at the 50, to the 40, to the 30. Fred Williams pulled down at the 11-yard line as the game is over. And the Oakland Invaders have managed to hang on to win 17-16. And by virtue of that victory, they have won the Pacific Division of the United States Football League in this, the inaugural year of play in the USFL. Well, Boston, I've got to think, Don Heinrich, was its own worst enemy. No question about it, as they had a rather strange play from Smith stepping out of bounds on the 5. A penalty took away, still another touchdown as Crump scored. Only a holding call negated that. And Boston really unable to overcome its own mistakes as they lost today by 1.
Well, you described it perfectly. Boston could not overcome the mistakes. They created many of them for themselves. They could not take advantages of some opportunities that they had. And when it's all said and done, Oakland just wanted it a little bit more.
And they managed to persevere, and indeed they did, to win it by a point, 17-16. Don, it's been a great season. Thank you for your invaluable help, and I've had a great time.